Good morning, students. You have learnt about the definition of a compound angle and the different formulae in the earlier sessions. That is, an angle which is expressed as the sum or difference of two or more angles, we call it as a compound angle. So in this chapter, we have studied the formula of sin A plus B, cos A plus B, tan A plus B. Similarly, sin A minus B, cos A minus B and tan A minus B. And we have worked out some problems where we have evaluated something, we have simplified some function. And in this, today's session, I am going to prove certain results here. So let me take up the first problem. So in all of them, I am proving certain results. The first problem is prove that sin of A plus B divided by cos A into cos B should be equal to tan A plus tan B. Tan A plus tan B. That is, look at the left hand side. We have to start from the left hand side, arrive at the right hand side. So sin of A plus B divided by cos A into cos B. Right hand side, of course, we don't have, here it is in the form of a fraction, whereas the right hand side is sum of the two tan ratios here. So denominator is a product of two functions, cos functions here. So start with the left hand side. Numerator is a compound angle. It is sin of A plus B divided by cos A into cos B. The answer can be obtained within two steps. So usually it can be expected for a 2-mark question. Now let me expand. Sin of A plus B, using the basic formula, it is sin A into cos B plus cos A into sin B. I am using the standard formula and write the denominator as it is. It is cos A into cos B. So numerator, because it is a compound angle formula, I have expanded. Sin of A plus B equal to sin A into cos B plus cos A into sin B. Write the denominator as it is. Look at the numerator. There are two terms here. There are two terms, and the denominator we are having only one term. That means both the terms of the numerator should be divided by the existing denominator. So let me split and write that one. First term is sin A into cos B. Whole thing divided by cos A into cos B. That means the first term I have divided by the denominator. Let me go to the second one. It is cos A into sin B divided by cos A into cos B. Cos A into cos B. That means, since there are two terms here, see, you know how to, when there are two fractions, how do you add them? By taking the LCM. Here, this becomes the LCM. So we have in the numerator addition of two terms here. So what I have done is, I have split into sum of two fractions here. That means dividing each term of the numerator by the existing denominator. So sin A cos B by cos A cos B. Cos A sin B by cos A cos B. Clearly we see that cos B can be cancelled. And in this case, cos A can be cancelled. What is remaining? Now it is sin A divided by cos A. And here it is sin B divided by cos B. Using the basic definition of the trigonometry function, sin A by cos A is nothing but tan A. And sin B by cos B is nothing but tan B. You clearly see that it is nothing but the right hand side. So we have started with the left hand side. You just observe, this is the left hand side. We have done the expansion, we have split the terms, and we have cancelled the common terms here, and we have written the remaining terms. Now, that's why I told you it can be given, it can be expected for a 2-mark question. One for writing the correct formula here, the compound angle formula, then splitting and writing the remaining thing. Now you will be getting the remaining mark for this one. So this is sin of A plus B divided by cos A cos B will be equal to tan of A plus tan of B. Now let me consider another problem. let me consider another problem where I can say it is a sort of extension of the this problem. Here, understand the problem correctly, then we'll try to solve them. Prove that sigma sine of A minus B divided by cos A into cos B should be equal to 0. When you have the right hand side to be 0, you can clearly understand that whatever terms we get on the left hand side, they should get cancelled. Then only we get 0 on the right hand side. Now look at this symbol. I hope you are familiar with this one. It is called as sigma. Sigma is a Greek alphabet here. Sigma stands for summation. Suppose I am considering a triangle ABC. I am writing some angle A. Angle ABC. Let me take the angle ABC. Now I am taking the sum of the angles. Let me take. It is ABC plus BCA plus ACB. Isn't it? So these are the three angles of a triangle. Now instead of writing all the three angles, I can write the first term and then use the symbol sigma. It is sigma angle ABC. Like this I can write. That means that see, sigma always stands for the summation. Suppose you are considering a triangle, there would be three quantities. Suppose you are considering a quadrilateral, there would be four such quantities. So how do you write this one? You have to change them in the cyclic order. What do you mean by cyclic order? Just like a cycle. Here, see, suppose this is A, this is B, this is C. Okay? Cyclic order means A becomes B, B becomes C, C goes back to A. So that is how we write here. See, A, B, C, B, C, A, and let me write it as C, A, B. Okay? You can write B, A, C also, C, A, B also. Both are correct here. So I am changing them in the cyclic order. A has become B, B has become C. B has become C, C has become A. C has become A has become B. That is called as changing the terms in the cyclic order. That means that if you simplify, that is, see here I have written only one term. That means there would be two more terms of the same type here. There would be two more terms of the same type. Now, it can be expected for a higher mark question, like 5 mark question. Now, you have to show that it is equal to 0. So, instead of writing all the terms and simplifying all the terms, in such cases, you can do one thing. Take first term here. Take the first term. Simplify using the compound angle formula. And as in the earlier problem, we will be having two terms in the numerator. Divide both the terms individually by the denominator. We will be getting two terms. In the previous problem, we got tan A plus tan B. Something like that we will be getting here also. Okay. After dividing, only simplify the first term. For the remaining two terms, you can write the terms without doing the calculation. That is, this one would be sine A minus B. What would the next one? Change them in cyclic order, sine B minus C. Then it becomes sine C minus A. Denominator also, cos A cos B becomes cos B cos C. Then cos B cos C becomes cos C cos A. Like that, even the denominator, they change in the cyclic order. So instead of doing the same calculation again and again three times here, you simplify the first term and then write the remaining two terms without showing the calculation but by changing the terms in the cyclic order. So this is the procedure we follow usually. You write this one, left hand side. Left hand side is sigma sine A minus B over cos A into cos B. That is equal to, first let me write the terms, then the idea becomes clear. Sine A minus B divided by cos A into cos B. That's a term that has been already given to us. Let me change them in the cyclic order. Now, what is the cyclic order? A becomes B, B becomes C. Then, denominator, it becomes cos B into cos C. Now, there would be one more term. So what I have done? Sin A minus B will become sin B minus C. Sin B minus C has become sin C minus C. Denominator, cos A cos B has become cos B cos C. Cos B cos A has become cos A cos A. So these are the three terms. When you just remove the symbol here, when you write the symbol, it is enough to write only one term. The remaining two terms would be written, changing them in the cyclic order. So here, for each one, you have to write the expansion of this, expansion of that, expansion. Divide both the terms by this one. Divide both the terms by this one. Divide both the terms by that one. So the same type of calculation, instead of repeating that one, what I do is, right, don't write LHS. That is already written. Consider the first term, or for that matter any term you can take. Consider sin A minus B divided by cos A into cos B. Cos A into cos B. Now, what did we do in the previous problem? We expanded the numerator. So let me do the expansion here. It is sin A into cos B minus cos A into sin B. Whole thing divided by cos A into cos B. I am considering only the first term. That is why I have written, I have not written, here I have written LHS. Whereas here I have written consider. That means only the first term I am considering. Now, as in the earlier one, you can split the terms and write. That is sin A into cos B divided by cos A into cos B minus the second term. Cos A into sin B divided by cos A into cos B. Which can be cancelled here? First one, cos B can be cancelled. Second one, cos A can be cancelled. What is remaining now? Sin A by cos A, that would be equal to tan A. Minus sin B by cos B, that is equal to tan B. So, by simplifying the first term, only the first term, instead of writing this one, I could write it as tan A minus tan B. Now, the same thing we have to do for this one also. So, instead of A and B, what you will be getting? Sin B cos A minus cos B sin C. Divide by this one, you will be getting, if you change this also in the cyclic order, A becomes B and B becomes C. So after doing this calculation, now you start with the left hand side. So consider, you do in the main column only. Now you write the left hand side equal to first term. How did you simplify? It is tan A minus tan B for the first one. So A was there, A we have written. B was there, B have written. So what can be the next two terms here? A will become B. So it would be tan B and B becomes C. That means tan C. That is over. Come to the last one. So B would be changed over to C and B would be changed over to C and C would be changed over to A. Okay. Now, these are the terms here. So, simplify any one of them. Need not be the first one. You can take the second or third. The same calculation will be done. Look at this one. It is plus tan A and minus tan A. That is cancelled. Then, plus tan B, minus tan B, plus tan B. That is also cancelled. And then, minus tan C plus tan C. So what did you get here? All the terms, now they get cancelled. Hence, that is equal to the right hand side. So, in the previous problem, I had considered only one part, not the sigma notation, or this much taken. Instead of minus, I had plus. What was the answer I had got there? Tan A plus tan B. Here, the denominator is same. Numerator, I consider the other compound angle, sin A minus B. But instead of one term, I am having three terms here. But only first term is written. The sigma notation is given. That means the remaining two terms have to be written. After writing, Take any one of them, do the simplification applying the compound angle formula. The remaining two terms, the simplification of the remaining two terms could be directly written by changing them in the cyclic order. So that now all the six terms have been cancelled. Hence we are having the answer 0, which was expected on the right hand side. So this is the procedure. So wherever you have the sigma notation, if a particular answer is expected on the right hand side, better, and if each term needs some simplification, that is important. If each term needs some simplification on the left hand side, write first all the terms, changing them in the cyclic order. Take any one of them, simplify, then write the simplified form of the other two terms by changing them in the cyclic order. Then in all the cases you may not get 0 there. So whatever answer you get, you will be, whatever answer you are expecting on the right hand side, you will be getting that one. So this is the procedure we have to follow. Now let me consider another problem. Here sine of A plus B, sine of A plus B divided by sine of A minus B. This is equal to tan A plus tan B divided by tan A minus tan B. Tan A minus tan B. Now here again, left hand side, we are having compound angles, sine A plus B, sine A minus B. Right hand, of course, this is also a fraction, this is also a fraction. Whereas the right hand side, numerator is sum of two tan ratios, denominator the difference of two tan ratios. Whereas on the left hand side, we are having only sine function or sine ratio. That, and the basic thing you know that tan theta is equal to sine theta by cos theta. So remembering that basic information and using the expansions of sine A plus B, sine A minus B, we have to do some manipulation here to arrive at the right hand side. So little bit of thinking is needed. In the earlier problems, it is direct expansion and splitting the terms, we could get the answer directly. Whereas here, we have to think a little bit to arrive at the right hand side. First, let me start with the left hand side. Sine A plus B. Let me write the expansion. What is that one? Sin A cos B plus cos A sin B. Now denominator, you know that when the sign is changed, terms are same, only the sign is different. Sin A cos B minus cos A into sin B. See, in the earlier problems, numerator we had the expansion, denominator there was only one term, isn't it? Therefore, we could split that one, we divided both the terms of the numerator by the existing denominator, because denominator there was only one term here. Whereas here, numerator contains two terms, denominator contains two terms, we cannot do the division here. If there were to be only one term, we could do that one. Because there are two terms there are two terms here. Don't divide this by this and this by that. That's not correct at all. So we have to think of some other method to arrive at the result. At this stage, look at the right hand side. We do not want sin A, cos B, all those things. We want only tan A here. We want only tan B here. Similarly, tan A and tan B, they are positive, minus. That is already there. Numerator we are having plus sign, denominator minus sign. So sin we need not bother, but we have to get the tan here. So look at the first term here. Sin A, you know the tan theta is sin theta by cos theta. So if you divide sin A by cos A, naturally you will be getting tan A. Similarly, here if you divide sin B by cos B, you will be getting tan B. Okay. Now this cos B we do not want. This cos A we do not want in the numerator. That means that if you divide the numerator by cos A into cos B. See, in the previous two problems, it was given in the denominator. So you need not think about that. Here you have to think about that one. If you divide the both the numerator terms by cos A, cos B, first case cos B cancels, Second case, cosine cancels, you will be having tan A and tan B. That's what we want on the right hand side. But if you divide only the numerator, the value gets altered. The value would be different. That means that you cannot do that one. Whatever adjustment or manipulations you do, then it should not change the value of the given expression. Suppose you divide the numerator, you have to divide the denominator. If you add something, you have to subtract something. If you multiply, you have to divide. So those opposite operations you have to do. Then only it comes to a simple form and the value doesn't get altered. That always you have to remember. That is why immediately we say add and subtract something. Multiply and divide by something. So that by doing two opposite operations, value will not be changed, but the given expression or whatever it is given there, it comes to a simple form. That means that divide the numerator by cos A cos B, you have to divide the denominator also by cos A and cos B. So how do you write that one? Divide the numerator. Divide the numerator and denominator. Denominator by cos A into cos B. By cos A into cos B. Now suppose answer is some cot A, cot B, something like that, then you should have divided by sin A into sin B. So always they may change the terms here in the examination. Instead of tan, if it is given as cot, you have to think that it has to be divided by sin A into sin B. So let me divide both the numerator and denominator by a common quantity. So right here, this line, write a little bit length here. First term, sin A into cos B divided by cos A into cos B divided by this one. Next one, cos A into sin B. Now divide this also by cos A into cos B. So there are two terms in the numerator. Both of them have been divided by a common number. Next, denominator, sin A into cos B divided by cos A into cos B. Now here minus cos A into sin B divided by cos A into cos B. See, we are not, the value has not been changed because we have divided the numerator, we have divided the denominator. That to both the terms of the numerator as well as both the terms of the denominator. We clearly see that some terms are getting cancelled. Here, cos B cancels, cos A cancels. Cos B cancels, cos A cancels. Let us see what is remaining now. It is sin A by cos A. That is tan A. Sin B by cos B, that is tan B. Divided by sin A by cos A, again tan A. And this is tan B. And that is what we wanted on the right hand side. Okay. So the left hand side, it was given. The two compound angle formula was given to us, sin of A plus B and sin of A minus B. Right hand side was tan A plus tan B over tan A minus tan B. So what did we do? First we expanded the numerator as well as the denominator. After expansion, we divided both the numerator, denominator by a common quantity cos A into cos B. So that after cancellation, numerator would be tan A plus tan B, denominator is tan A minus tan B. Suppose in the answer it was given as cot A cot B and cot A cot B here in the denominator, you should have divided by sin A into sin B. Or the problem can also be given in the reverse order. This may be the left hand side, this may be the right hand side. In that case, no, suppose it will be asked like this, prove that tan A plus tan B over tan A minus tan B is equal to sin A plus B over sin A minus B. Even that can be asked, that way it can be asked. In that case, no, what you have to do, when it is in terms of sin means, first you have to think that tan A should be written as sin A by cos A. Tan B should be written as sin B by cos B. Same thing in the denominator. So instead of one term, we'll be having a fraction. And here also it would be a fraction. Here also, here also. So when you have addition of two fractions or difference of two fractions, what is the method we adopt? We take the LCM. So LCM becomes here cos A into cos B here also, and then it comes to this particular form. That common LCM for the numerator denominator, they get cancelled, it gets cancelled. We will be left with this one, sin A cos B plus cos A sin B, sin A cos B minus cos A sin B. That means that we are going backwards, starting with this one and writing the value of tan A by sin A by cos A, same thing in all the places, taking the LCM, we come to this particular stage. Here, you can write it as, it is sin of A plus B, the numerator, sin of A minus B, the denominator. So, whatever way the problem is asked, no, we have to think here. So, here to here, we have to do the division. Here to here, we have to take the, write it as sin A by cos A and take the LCM and use the compound angle formula, you can write the answer. So this is the procedure we adopt here. So each problem would be a little bit different from the previous problem. So some problem direct expansion or starting with directly left hand side using a particular formula which is applicable to that, we'll be getting the result. But some problems, a little bit thinking is needed, as in this particular problem. So in the next session, we'll be working out some more problems on again the compound angles only. Thank you.